Well, joining us now on the line to talk more about that card fraud that Arabelle mentioned at the end of those news headlines, the fraud involving banks and fast food outlets, is Walter Faulke, CEO of PASA. Good morning, Walter. I suppose two questions immediately come to mind. How did this fraud work, and how did it take so long, if tens of millions of rand have been lost, to detect?
Yeah, it's, I must say it was one of the most malicious and complicated fraud cases that we've had to deal with. Essentially, it seems like an international syndicate managed to embed one of these malicious malware pieces of software into a number of servers into certain segments of the retail market. What the software would do is capture any magstripe data that went through for authorization to the banks. And then that data was shipped off to the syndicate, which then used it to create the production of fraudulent cards. So that's in essence, how the syndicate worked.
And then how long did it take? If tens of millions of rand have been lost, it's hard to know what the traffic of money is at these outlets every day. It must be substantial. Yes. How long did it take to find out?
Well, we started detecting unusual levels of fraud early in the year already, so going back many months. Initially, we just started monitoring the levels, not quite sure what the cause was. And eventually, when it just kept on rising, and I mean, initially, these were small numbers, relatively speaking, we eventually formed an incident response committee, which then appointed a forensics investigation company to target specific retail outlets to try and determine the problem. It took them quite a while to eventually find this malware inside the server system of some of these retail outlets. Obviously, once we detected what the problem is, it actually was quite quick to develop an anti-malware software and to start cleaning up the sites that were affected. So the whole process took many months. But fortunately, as we speak, that's all clean.
Well, they talk about a syndicate. One imagines someone somewhere sitting down saying, let's look at which country we're going into, South Africa. Let's look at a particular sector, fast foods. How would they choose South Africa, and why would they choose the fast food sector in particular?
Yeah. Now, I think these guys just scan, globally, so I don't think it was particularly South Africa. I'm sure they're working in all kinds of countries. I think they found a lucky break at one of the sites in South Africa, and once you get into one of the sites, it is a little bit easier to get the malware distributed via the internet to other sites. So, I think they're constantly looking at weak links, and, single chink in the armor can give them a nice into, a whole industry sector. And I don't think it was fast foods particularly or anything like that. It was just that's where they happened to find a chink in their armor this time.
So who's lost out here? One thinks of the consumer going to buy the food, one thinks of the outlet, and one thinks of the bank. Apparently it's the banks who've lost the money.
Yes, that's usual. That's where the buck stops. The issuing bank typically loses the money first, so certainly not the cardholder. The issuing bank is obviously within their right to require the acquiring bank to reimburse the funds if they feel that there's been negligence in any way. And in turn, the acquiring bank can claim any losses from a merchant, again, if there's sufficient proof that there was negligence in any way, non-compliance to PCI standards, not supporting EMV, all those security requirements that we're starting to insist on.
Now, the number I've heard is tens of millions of rand. Can you make a more precise number about how much has been stolen here? And are all the banks equally affected, or are some suffered more than others?
No, I think they're all pretty equally affected. I think those banks that rolled out chip cards quicker are probably slightly less affected. So the effect was more on those cards, credit cards and check cards that are still magstripe based and signature based. Those are the ones that were really affected. So any bank that's still got some magstripe cards out there would have been more affected, but in general, sort of across the board.
Yeah.
There are also still fraud numbers coming through as we speak, although the source of the fraud breach has been blocked quite some weeks ago. But obviously there's still quite a bit in the pipeline, and we have to monitor those in the next 2 weeks and months.
Okay, finally, another name that comes to mind with this is Paygate, which happened, I think, last year, Walter. Is this as bad as that? Worse?
Unfortunately, probably slightly worse. I think Paygate was one particular internet service provider, so it was a bit more ring-fenced, although it was massive, you know, at that scale. This is smaller amounts, more widely spread, and the view is that probably the ultimate number will be bigger than the Paygate incident.
Well, thanks, Walter, who is CEO of the Payments Association of South Africa.